Wendy Williams has resurfaced in the news, but not for good reasons. Her health has taken a turn for the worse, and she is not doing well at all. But she's not alone in her troubles, because Sharona Hudson and Kevin Hunter are also facing a lot of problems. They have hit rock bottom, and it's over for them. Wendy was spotted in New York in March 2023, looking very weak and frail. This raised a lot of alarm among her fans and friends, who were worried about her condition. This was months after some videos went viral, showing her like this.
Hey Wendy,
hi.
How you doing?
Fine, thanks.
You're looking good.
Thank you. Can I have your hand, please? Can I have your hand?
Oh, what?
Somebody's hand.
Somebody,
take your hand. Thank you. Can you walk the other way, please?
Wendy Williams had a wild night out in New York City, but it was not a happy occasion. She drank a lot, from Fresco by Scott to the Townhouse, a gay bar. Rob Shooter, who spoke to Page Six, said Wendy looked lonely by herself, but she brightened up when she saw a familiar face. He also talked about their encounter on his podcast, saying Wendy invited everyone to her table. Wendy kept saying she wanted to get drunk, and she didn't care who saw her. She was clearly out of it, because after dinner, the group went to the gay cocktail lounge, where Wendy asked the doorman, "Do you watch the Wendy Williams show?" "I'm Wendy Williams." And that was the last time anyone saw or heard from her, until recently, when her old friend and radio personality Miss Jones from 94.7 The Beat revealed some new details. Miss Jones said she tried to visit Wendy Williams after months of her co-workers telling her to check on her. But when she got to her Manhattan apartment building, she told the doorman she was there to see Wendy Williams, and he said, "You're a couple of months late." She moved. Miss Jones said she asked around the building for more information, and she was told by others, "Well, you know what happened. She was getting better. She was coming around, and then she got sick again." Miss Jones also said that Wendy's family moved her to Florida because they were worried about her. She said people were coming into her circle that they didn't know or trust, and they couldn't get access to her when they wanted. She said Wendy is in Florida with her son, trying to recover, because her health is getting worse. Wendy's house in New York is not for sale, so maybe she hopes to get better and come back to New York. But it might take a while, because reports say her health has worsened in the last few weeks. A clip that Wendy's team sent as a promo for the Women's Expo event, which Wendy canceled at the last minute, also leaked. And from the video, you can see that things have been bad for a long time. Wendy even said that she is still married to her ex-husband, Kevin Hunter, the one she divorced and left with nothing.
Hi, it's me, Wendy. Wendy Williams, but my real name is Wendy Hunter. I'm married to Hunter. Anyway, Wendy Williams, I'm going to be at the Women's Empowerment Expo. It's going to be Saturday, May 20th. Please be there. It's very important.
She then went off script and said something that shocked everyone.
They told me it would only take like 20 minutes. Please, let me tell you something, girls. It's going to take an hour. I've got so much stuff to talk to you about, okay? So I'll see you there. Bye.
The video shows that Wendy was not okay, but her team wanted to use it anyway. They said she was fine, but the expo disagreed. They said the video was unusable and that Wendy looked very confused. A close source said the expo team was also worried that the video of Wendy saying she was still married to her ex Kevin would anger people, especially the Women's Expo audience who supported women's empowerment. Wendy's son Kev Jr. also spoke out against her team. He said they were exploiting her wealth, fame, and poor judgment. He said he thought Wendy's health was ignored while others were making money from her projects. He told The Sun in an interview, "As hard as it is seeing her being taken advantage of, I know that if I'm making sure she as a person is okay, that is the important thing, because eventually she's going to realize the craziness that's been going on." He said the people around her cared more about her income than her health, and he didn't think that was right. He also confirmed that Wendy moved from New York months ago. He said in the interview, "I can confirm that Wendy Williams is not in the hospital as reported. I can also confirm that she is not in New York. Wendy's brother Tommy also shared some details about Wendy's health after visiting her in Florida while she was working on a documentary. He told the US Sun that Wendy was not in a good mental state to do a show. He said, "Why are you even here? Do you see the condition she's in? Does it look like she's ready to start a podcast? For goodness sake, it doesn't. And we are all going to witness this. This guy will is dragging Wendy around. Travel here, travel there, let's go make this money. And he doesn't care if you're making sense, because everybody knows who you are." Tommy also said that Wendy opened a secret bank account, not linked to her official accounts, which were under a conservatorship. But he said Wendy didn't know or forgot how banks work. He said she opened the account and wanted to use it to get money from selling her stuff. He said she told people who wanted to pay her to go to the bank and say it was for Wendy Williams's account. But he said her plan didn't work because people needed her bank account information to transfer money. He said Wendy's accounts were locked. That also meant that Kevin and Sharona were locked out as well, and they are both in a bad situation. Kevin tried to sue Wendy because he couldn't pay his bills. He sold the house he shared with Sharona and borrowed money from a company called Flex Wealth to buy two luxury cars. He was also sued by UBS Bank for not paying his credit card debts. UBS said Kevin got a Visa signature card in 2014, but he didn't pay what he owed. UBS said Kevin owed more than $20,000 plus lawyer fees. When the money stopped coming, Sharona and Kevin's relationship suffered. There were reports that Sharona left Kevin after he ran out of money.
Now, I am hearing that her ex-husband Kevin and Sharona are no longer together, and you know what that is.
Well, come on now.
The money gone.
But Sharona is also in more legal trouble because she got sued by Synchrony Bank for not paying her TJ Maxx card. The amount is over $3,000, which was nothing when they were living off of Wendy's money. But now that Wendy stopped sending them checks, Sharona and Kevin are broke. They are having a hard time raising their daughter, Journey, who used to enjoy the good life thanks to Wendy's money. Karma is really catching up with them. But there's some good news for Wendy. Her friend Miss Jones confirmed that Wendy is with her family in Florida, and no one is taking advantage of her or her health. Miss Jones also shaded Wendy's ex and his mistress, saying Wendy won. She said Diddy went to jail for Easter, and Kevin can't get Wendy's money. She said the judge denied Kevin's request, and Wendy can stop now. She said the jig is up. It's not the best news, but what do you think about the update on Wendy? Are you happy that she's back at home in Florida? And what do you think of Kevin and Sharona's downfall? Let me know in the comments below.